You don't appreciate your life until you go over it. I'm looking at a man named Ira Young, who was the builder, developer of the Coquitlam Center that I lived next to for a few years of my childhood, teenage years. It turns out he was a psychiatrist trained. Ira Young, but look at this mall. The largest stained glass in the world was implemented, and all wooden ceilings. There's the bay. You should have seen this mall. It was beautiful, and it's completely gutted now. But look at the food fair. All wooden. I mean, this mall was eclipsed. The one in Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Right around the corner here was an arcade, but we hung out here all the time as teenagers. Did I know it would disappear in 10 years? It only lasted 10 years. Even Bob Mackey came here. Here's the second floor. I mean, you could walk here forever. This is a tree coming up onto the second floor, growing from the bottom floor. Here's the concourse. But here they describe it. In addition to magnificent windows, 20 works of sculpture by local artists were placed throughout the mall. Well, sculpture nowadays. And it was adorned with lush tropical plants imported from Florida. The Columbia newspaper reported that the mall contained 110 tropical trees and 800 to 900 plants, including rubber, weeping fig, Indian laurel, cocoa palms, and screw pines. And I just remember always going there, and just every time my mother drove me crazy, I would just go to the mall. And it was fantastic. It was a place to run to. Where do young people have to run to now? All we do is run to these little fucking cell phones? Nah, not me. External landscaping included 4.7 acres planted with trees and 11,000 square feet seeded with other plants. I remember this. It was so fun to take this place over. But I mean, there's the groundbreaking around 77, and grand opening was around 1979. Well, thanks, Ira, but what happened? Did you build it just to sell it out and destroy it? The most beautiful mall ever? But yeah, there is a pyramid there, hey? Sunlight poured in. A big steel man, Fairweather. Susie Cream Cheese, Frederick's, or what was the name of that store? I even worked there at Chez Lierre for a while. It was the best fried chicken in the world. Really cute guys would come by, and I would give them an extra piece of chicken or something. What else? I mean, there it is. There it is in Coquitlam. The aerial, but it's gone now. There's Bob, Phyllis Esposito, Bob Mackey even came. Like, this is a tiny little town, Coquitlam. This is the same town that Dorothy Stratton came from, the Dairy Queen. It wasn't Vancouver, it was Coquitlam. And Walk with Jan was also filmed there. It doesn't say that on the internet, but it was on Industrial Way in Burquitlam. But I'm pissed off because all these this mall, you go into it and it's totally different. They ripped out all of these beautiful atriums, and they ripped out all of the stuff and replaced it with a maze. The only thing maybe original is the stained glass windows, but nobody's paying attention because it's all white. It's probably painted white. Like, it's like that Rolling Stones song. Instead of painted black, everything's painted white. That's like the color of craziness.